It is me, Jordan Byers, and today we're gonna be brutally, honestly reviewing the new Jeffree Star. Oh, I was holding it upside down. Smooth, Jordan, smooth. We're gonna be reviewing the new Jeffree Star Androgyny Eyeshadow Palette. And you guys know that I've been excited about this. If you follow me on Twitter, I get a little bit excited about makeup. That is what the packaging looks like. This is what the palette looks like. It's got like faux hot pink crocodile leather, gold writing. It's the exact same size as the Beauty Killer palette. So if you have this one, they're the exact same size. Just giving you a little bit of a reference, if that makes sense. First, okay, but if you don't have either of these palettes, they are big. Like, when I saw these palettes online, I was not expecting to be getting this huge of a palette. So let me just reference it to something that's relevant-ish. So here we have the Too Faced Peach, Sweet Peach palette. This is how big it is compared to the Jeffree Star palettes. So as you can see, this is like a normal size palette. Jeffree's palettes are huge and I love them. They're also really thin compared to a lot of tin packaged products. So that's just a little bit about the packaging, but to be completely honest, it's not always about the packaging. Packaging is important, but it's about what's inside.
It's like beauty. It's not always about what's on the outside, it's about what's on the inside. Inner beauty is so important.
I'm serious though, like inner beauty, it shines through. Let me tell you, it really does. It really does. I'm not joking around this time. Okay, so this is what the palette looks like. 10 shadows in here. And I've been playing around with this for a while because, as you know, I did a review on this one right here. And basically, I loved all of the shades except for this gold one. It just didn't really show up at all. It just wasn't really pigmented at all. But all of the other shades are extremely pigmented. I literally use this on a daily basis, actually. This shade right here, Courtney, absolutely amazing. And this shade, China White, is awesome for your base or like setting it over a primer. That's just what I use it for. So obviously I already love Jeffree's formula for eyeshadows. All of these shadows are actually fantastic pigmented. I did a look today using this palette and the other palette, and I'm wearing Androgyny on my lips just because I thought it was fitting. Androgyny palette, I need to put Androgyny on my lips. That's that. Let me talk about this for a second. So the one bad thing about this palette, and don't worry, I am gonna swatch all of the shades, tell you about the formula, etc., etc., but first let me tell you why this palette I feel like is not a standalone palette. Like, you couldn't travel with this palette just by itself. Like, you would need to bring this one or another one with other neutral shades. And here's why. There is no white shade or cream shade to set your primer, because I know when I put a primer on my eyes, I always like to use a skin tone or white or cream or something light to set that primer, because if you don't set it in and you just go in with a purple or a green, it's just gonna be super blotchy because it's gonna be sticking to the primer in different sections and different way, if that makes sense. But that's just me. The other thing that I thought was a little bit weird about this palette is kind of the way it's set up. Listen, I love pops of color, but I feel like these blue shades and the green really don't fit in with all of the other shades. And here's what I was thinking. I was thinking like, oh, you could use this color with the blues and greens, and then you could use the oranges with the purple sometimes, or the red with these colors, or like the blue and the brown. But here's the thing, my mind gets like so distracted by all of the colors, I get like scared, and then I don't really know how to work with it, if that makes sense. And that's not Jeffree's fault. That's my fault. But I feel like if it was packaged in a way where I don't know, like if the blues were right next to the brown and this color called Safe Word, if it was like that, like the brown's right next to the blue and then the red and the purple up here next to this bronze and the orange, I feel like it would be like a better layout, but that's just me. I don't know if he was trying to do like all of the natural colors here and all the non-natural colors. I don't know what was going on, but I feel like I definitely am going to depot this because I noticed myself having to reach a lot into this one to find shades that match, like, you know, do you know what I mean? I don't know if you know what I mean. This is getting long. Let's just do some swatches. Okay, so here is the entire palette swatched on my arm. As you can see, I just feel like these colors right here, I don't know. I really don't know. But I did a whole look just using these two blue colors in a previous video. It was where the one where I was wearing like a gray purple lipstick and I had like a blue eyeshadow look. Loved it. Used these colors. Absolutely loved it. Listen. I love every single shade in this palette except for this green just because it reminds me of puke. In the second grade, my best friend puked on me during chapel and it was that exact shade. So every time I see this palette and I see that color called military, it does not remind me of the brave soldiers fighting for our country every single day. It reminds me of my best friend's puke all over me. And that's just what I think of. So that kind of scares me a little bit. I don't really know how that would look flattering on an eye. I don't know. It just doesn't seem like a very pretty color to me, but that's just because I have those memories. And that's just my opinion. If you guys like this color, I'm not saying it's an ugly color. I'm just saying the memories behind that color are a little bit traumatizing, not gonna lie. And it was the day of the zoo field trip, so I didn't get to go to the zoo. The one thing that I wish he did was I kind of wish that these two palettes were like kind of switched and some of the colors in this one were in this one and like just swapped, because I feel like the palettes, some of the colors would look better in the other one, just my opinion. So like I feel like this color called Expensive would look better in a palette with these colors, and then like this color right here called Confession would, like this color and this color and like the gold would fit in a lot better in this palette. And if you just swapped those colors right there and swap these blue colors, put them in this one, put those in that one. I'm saying a lot of words that probably aren't really making any sense. Basically what I'm saying is that I'm probably going to depot these and put them in the order that I like them together. I'm kind of sad that I'm gonna have to depot these, but to be completely honest, it just is gonna help my brain a little bit more because I just need it, okay?
5 minutes later.
It is a sad day. It is a very sad day. I broke it. I am not a delicate butterfly. My whole life, my mom has called me an elephant because I am so destructive and loud, and it is true. I just broke the color black rainbow.
Seconds later.
You guys, this is literally impossible.
Take me to my fantasy. Tell me we can make this real. And we can follow what we feel. I'm running, but I've reached the edge. And now I'm falling, so promise that you'll catch me.
This is what I get for trying to stay organized. One of my favorite colors, China White, just popped all of the way out. Why am I doing this to myself? Why am I doing this to my favorite makeup? I don't know, but I'm pissed. Nuggets, I'm gonna fix that though. I'm gonna fix that. Listen, I know. I made a mess. I made a really, 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 really big mess. But look, it's completed in the way that I would like it to be. Yes. A handful of my shadows cracked all over my hands and I fixed them with some rubbing alcohol, but I'm just glad that it's over. Do I recommend depotting the Jeffree Star palettes? absolutely don't do it. Absolutely do not. Whoa. The microphone just completely fell off the camera. Absolutely, I do not. I do not recommend depotting these bad boys. It has been an experience, but I'm in denial. I hope that you enjoyed this video. Thank you very much for watching. I will see you in the next video. Subscribe, give this video a big ol' thumbs up because, just give it a thumbs up because I broke so many shadows today and I'm really sad about it, okay? Like, I'm actually devastated, but I'm holding back my tears for this video because I'm an actress, okay? Like, okay. Bye, guys. What the heck? Was that like some ASMR type stuff? Like, that's creepy. Anyways, bye. I'm actually so sad inside because I had to repair so many of them, but it looks good all together, right? Do I regret it a little bit? Probably. Am I glad that it's over? Most definitely.